Let's run some speed test. The 11 Pro Max here on the right versus the 10S Max here on the left. Let's first just start with going through some apps and see which one opens faster. Nothing is running in the background. Let's start up with the clock here. You see, opens almost the same speed. Weather, again, same speed on both of them. Let's go into App Store. Of course, both of those phones are connected to the same Wi-Fi network, so that shouldn't be the difference. But camera here, and opens up just as fast. But of course, the 10S Max is on the front-facing camera, so let's just run that one again and hit the camera at the same time. You can see it takes almost the same, a little faster maybe, on the 10S Max. Let's see the browsing speed between the two. Same Wi-Fi network again. And let's just go to the same website and hit go at exactly the same time and see which one loads the page fastest. First, my own website. You can see on the right here, definitely faster on the 11 Pro Max. Let's just go to another site, bbc.com. Hit enter the same time. Oh, pretty much exactly the same. Let's go to the last one here, cnn.com. Let me just type in the URL here. And let's hit the enter key at the same time. And you can see they loaded the page almost identically fast. So yeah, definitely not any real speed improvements in web browsing, at least not on those pages we just tried, except for my own page, of course. Let's go to the home app. Opened almost the same speed on both of the devices. Let's try and open the Philips Hue app. These are apps I use often or frequently at home. You can see it refreshed a little faster on the 11 Pro Max, but definitely not fast on the 10S Max. Of course, I'm running iOS 3 or 13.1 on both phones. So identical software versions. eBay here was a little faster on 11 Pro Max. Let's try the next app here, IKEA app. Let's see which one loads it faster. And yeah, about the same on both. Let's try AliExpress, see which one opens faster. And 11 Pro Max was definitely faster there at least loading the content. And what should we try next? Let's try some streaming apps. YouTube first. Of course, I'm logged into same account on both phones, and you can see the 11 Pro Max definitely loaded the content faster. Let's try YouTube Music. And let's see which is faster. And again, 11 Pro Max definitely loaded the faster, even though I got a pop-up screen here on the 11 Pro Max. Let's try Apple Music. And 11 Pro Max definitely faster, but I had not really set it up on my 10S Max. But you can see, going to the same screen, let's just try and close both of them down. And let's open them again and see which one is faster this time. And they're pretty much the same, not to say maybe exactly the same second time around. Let's try some more apps, this time Netflix. Logged into same account again on same Wi-Fi network on both phones. Wi-Fi 6, 1 gigabit connection. And you can see 11 Pro Max definitely was a lot faster at pulling in the content. And 10S Max here still struggling. And now finished. So yeah, definitely took quite a bit longer on the 10S Max on the Netflix app. Let's try and go to the Apple TV app here. And you can see 10S Max was actually quite a bit faster, but they also opened on different pages. Let's just try actually and close down again and open up TV app here. And you can see 11 Pro Max was faster at pulling the content, yes, yet again here. Let's try Sonos, also an app I use frequently. Okay, opened up in different parts of the app. So let's just close down the little pop-up notification and close down the app and open it again, hopefully opening in the same page. And you can see 11 Pro Max was definitely faster here. So yeah, that's kind of the story, I think. I think the 11 Pro Max is actually just a hair faster than 10S Max, not a noticeable difference if you don't have those two side by side to compare, but definitely I do feel like the 11 Pro Max is a little bit snappier, even though both of them is running iOS 13. Let's try Face ID. One of the things that got faster with 10S Max with iOS 13, but Apple said at least that the 11 Pro Max should be faster and be able to use Face ID at much lower angles or at wider angles. So yeah, let's just try them here side by side, just looking straight ahead. So both phones should at least look at or register my eyes easily at fast. And you can see, pressing the power button on and off here, just logging into Face ID. It does appear that the 11 Pro Max actually is a little faster sometimes, but again, then 10S Max sometimes seems to be faster. So I think it's pretty inconclusive which phone is actually faster. Both of them is very fast. And I have noticed maybe the 11 Pro Max is better off angle a little bit, but it took some days to actually get there because, you know, it does learn your face over time and should improve with time and machine learning and so on. But yeah, definitely not conclusively or a lot faster, maybe just a hair faster when it comes to Face ID. Yeah, let's get into benchmarking. Geekbench 5, of course, the latest installment of Geekbench. You cannot directly compare Geekbench 5 results with Geekbench 4 results because it is pretty different. The Geekbench 5 will score a lot lower results than Geekbench 4. So yeah, definitely not something you want to compare, but you can of course compare results from Geekbench 5 between Geekbench 5 benchmark scores. Skipping ahead a little bit, the live iPhone 11 Pro Max was quite a bit faster getting those scores. You can see them right here. Single core score is 1330 and multi-core score is 3497. Let's just wait for that 10S Max to finish, and just finished right here. You can see a few seconds later, quite a significantly lower score, 1113 versus 2848 multi-core score. Definitely slower in benchmark, synthetic benchmark, but again, not really something you're gonna notice in everyday tasks. Let's run the compute benchmark and let's have a look at the results. So iPhone 11 Pro Max just about to finish, and just finished right here. You can see the score, 6298. The iPhone 10S Max is still running almost 1.5 minutes now, so it's definitely slower as well in the overall compute benchmark. And you can see here almost 2000 less in score. This is of course the metal score, 4641. So yeah, 11 Pro Max is faster. Will you notice it in everyday use? No, I don't think so. Only if you really are exporting a lot of video, 4K video and so on, really pushing your phone a lot, you will see some benefits from this speed improvement. But in day-to-day task, the 11 Pro Max is maybe a hair faster. One thing that is definitely not faster on the 11 Pro Max compared to the 10S Max or 10S series is 3D touch versus haptic touch. You can see here the 10S Max on the left just pops up immediately if you put some force to the screen, whereas you have to hold your finger a few seconds or split seconds more on the 11 Pro Max for the same content to pop up. So definitely that feels kind of a downgrade coming from a 10S Max and using Touch ID, you know, quite significantly. So I do kind of miss it. I've gotten a little used to haptic touch throughout the week I've used the 11 Pro Max, but it is definitely not faster and I do miss it. For instance, if I want to get into Wi-Fi settings, you can see how much faster it is on the 10S Max here on the left, and 11 Pro Max a lot slower because you have to wait a second more or so for that haptic touch to kick in. But yeah, let's connect to Wi-Fi. I'm gonna connect to two separate Wi-Fi. I have a tri-band Wi-Fi 6 router, so each phone will get their own band, so should potentially get full speed or full bandwidth on each band here. So let's just run a quick test here, connect the same server, and let's click go. Like said, I have a Wi-Fi 6 router, tri-band router, and I have a 1 gigabit connection, both up and down. And for some reason, you can see I get very slow transfer speed when I run both phones at the same time, even though they're connected to the same individual Wi-Fi network, which is kind of strange. I'm sure that this is an issue with my router and not the phone, so let's just try individually. Again, connected to the same router, 1 gig connections. Here you have Wi-Fi AC, which is, I guess, Wi-Fi 5 on the left, iPhone XS Max. And you can see here, download and upload just above the 500 megabits per second. And Wi-Fi 6 here, 11 Pro Max on the right. You can see I am getting a little faster download speed, not significantly faster, but upload speeds is actually slower. So let's try this one more time. You can see I'm connected to the same server, so that shouldn't be the issue here. So second run here, and you can see actually it's a little slower on Wi-Fi 6 on the 11 Pro Max. So yeah, definitely not faster with Wi-Fi 6, so shouldn't really be a reason to upgrade. But let's try the 2.4 gigahertz frequency. Of course, the other results was on 5 gigahertz band. Again, connected to same server. Let's just try and run it again and see at the same time and see actually what kind of results we are getting. I can see the 11 Pro Max is pulling a little ahead here, but of course they are fighting over bandwidth right now. And yeah, around 50 megabits per second download both at the same time, and upload the 10S Max is pulling ahead. But let's just try and run them individually, or individually, and let's measure that result. First off, starting with the 10S Max here on the left, Wi-Fi 6 still, but this time on the 2.4 gigahertz frequency. Oh, excuse me, this is a Wi-Fi 5 device, okay, of course, but on 2.4 gigahertz frequency, you can see getting 75 down and 82 up, not that impressive. Let's try the 11 Pro Max, see if that does any better here. And you can see it actually pulls ahead quite a bit to begin with, but it does just get around that 70 mark as well, 75 megabits per second. So definitely not any advantages going with 2.4 gigahertz frequency, 85 megabits, of course 10 megabits more. Upload was definitely faster on the 11 Pro Max. Let's run it again just to be certain, and let's just compare the results here. You can see just around the same, a little slower upload this time around for 2.4 gigahertz. This time, let's test LTE or 4G connectivity, turning off Wi-Fi completely, getting back into speed test. Same network on both phones. You can see Telenor 4G, same exact subscription and everything, so should not be the issue here. And let's select the same server, and let's just run the test again, both of them at the same time, to see if there's any speed differences if you are running at the same time. Of course, this is pulling data from the same server or from the same cell tower. So same time, you can see they're pretty close, almost around the 90 megabits per second mark on the 10S Max, 83 and 94, almost 95 on the 11 Pro Max. 11 Pro Max was actually faster here at download, but you can see when it comes to upload, actually the 10S Max is a little bit faster, at least with this cell tower nearest to my home here. Let's run them individually and let's see which one is fastest. You can see right off the bat, it is definitely a lot faster if you are not pulling data at the same time from the same tower with phones pretty close to each other, which probably could have any results on the speed as well. But yeah, you can see 76 megabits per second download, and upload is pretty much the same as before. Now let's try the 11 Pro Max, same exact network and subscription and server as you can see here, and let's just look at the results. It is actually a bit faster right off the bat, but it does slow down a little bit here, and you can see the end result is actually very, very close between the two. It does get around 20 megabits per second faster right at the end of the test here, but most of the time it was actually pretty close to the 10S Max speed-wise. Upload speed, slower for some reason, about 10 megabits per second slower. On the 11 Pro Max, let's just run this test again and let's have a look at the result. So second test here is about to finish. And you can see on the left, 10S Max, little faster upload and download speeds pretty much the same. And on the 11 Pro Max on the right, you can see almost exactly the same download speed. But upload speed is actually significantly slower on the 11 Pro Max. I'm not really sure what the issue is here, but definitely not gigabit LTE speeds on the 11 Pro Max compared to the 10S Max. So yeah, this has just been a quick speed test running a few apps, data and benchmarks between the 10S Max and the 11 Pro Max. You should definitely not upgrade if you want to get a much faster phone. The upgrades speed-wise is very limited, but definitely I do really prefer the better camera and the better battery life of the 11 Pro Max. So if that's something you're appreciating, you should really consider upgrading. I hope to see you again in a future video, but that's been it for this one. Take care.